Welcome to Back to Basics. In this episode, we will discuss how Overlay IPs can be leveraged for failover across availability zones to achieve high availability of SAP applications running on AWS. In my past experience, I have witnessed major interruptions to customer business operations due to power outages in data centers caused by natural disasters. In this instance, we could not recover the business-critical SAP applications on time as both the primary and standby databases were hosted within the same data center. These types of outages can cause expensive delays in product schedules and order deliveries for customers. One lesson learned from that outage was the necessity to host the primary and secondary databases in differing locations. As an AWS solutions architect and SAP subject expert, I worked with customers on their SAP applications migration journeys to AWS. I have guided customers in implementing best practices such as setting up failure monitoring, multiple location deployments, and automatic failovers to achieve a highly available architecture for SAP applications that better suited the needs of the customer. To achieve this, we used AWS Transit Gateway, Overlay IP address routing, and separated SAP cluster nodes across multiple availability zones to achieve high availability for SAP applications. Let's look at why Overlay IPs are used for routing. In multi-availability zone AWS architecture scenarios, you assign subnets to each AZ. Each of these configured subnets have a classless inter-domain routing called CIDR IP assignment from the VPC, which resides entirely within one AZ. This CIDR IP assignment cannot span multiple availability zones or be reassigned to the secondary instance in a differing AZ during a failover scenario. Because of this, AWS allows you to configure Overlay IPs outside of your VPC CIDR block to access the active SAP instance. With Overlay IP routing, you can allow the AWS network to use a non-overlapping private IP address that resides outside a VPC CIDR range and direct the SAP traffic to any instance set up across the AZ within the VPC by changing the routing entry in AWS. Once traffic is received on this address, an AWS route table configuration is leveraged to route the traffic to a relevant EC2 instance using the attached Elastic Network Interface, ENI. A route table contains a set of rules that determine where network traffic from your subnet or gateway is directed. In the case of an Overlay IP, this route is edited by specifying the destination as the Overlay IP address and the target as the ENI of the instance for which you wish to use Overlay IP. Be sure that the Overlay IPs are consistent with your overall private IP schema and there are no IP conflicts with subnets used elsewhere. Your user client application then makes a request using the destination Overlay IP address. An AWS route table entry specifies to which EC2 instance your Overlay IP traffic gets routed. This Overlay IP address can be reached from any subnet within the same VPC that has been associated with the route table containing the Overlay IP routing entry. The traffic is routed to the ENI of the instance, which then checks the destination as Overlay IP. The Overlay IP at this point acts as the local IP address for this instance and then processes the task. An SAP HANA database or SAP NetWeaver application that is protected by a cluster solution uses the Overlay IP address assigned to ensure that your HA cluster is still accessible during failover scenarios. In case of a cluster failover, your routing table is updated, usually by a cluster software, which changes the target to the ENI of the other instance. If you do not have an AWS Transit Gateway set up as a network transit hub or if the service is not available in your preferred AWS region, you can use a network load balancer to enable network access to an overlay IP address. In this episode, we looked at a concept of overlay IP usage when SAP clusters are configured in multiple availability zones to achieve high availability during the event of an interruption or failure. Check out the links in the description below for more details. Thank you for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.